Hey guys, this is Dr. Sangeet and welcome back to another lecture of Dental Pathshala where we help you understand and learn dentistry better and easy way. And today's topic of discussion is the impression materials classification. So as we know that this is a very important question which has been asked frequently in the UG and PG exam, both the exams UG as well as PG, because see, theories of impression making is very important. Then classification of impression material itself is a directly question which is asked frequently. So today's topic is the impression materials classification. Before we get started, make sure you subscribe to our channel because it's free. You are getting all the information, all the lectures free of cost, and as soon as I upload a lecture, immediately you will get a notification if you click on the bell icon. So without further ado, let's get started on the impression materials classification. So before starting the classification of the impression materials, let's understand what is the impression as well as what is the impression material. So impression is, if you have attended any class of a new teacher, so that sometimes it is in your head that what should be my first impression on that teacher. If you are in a conference, if you are in a meeting, or if you meet any individual, any stranger or a person for a first time, so that is the impression we make, is the first impression, and it is in our head that we want to make the best first impression, right? You want to make the impression of yourself as a studious and an intelligent person or intelligent student. So what is impression basically? Impression is basically an imprint. Imprint. We want to leave an imprint that we are studious, that I am intelligent. So it is an imprint. See, complete denture, when it comes to the materials for the complete denture, CD, or if we are talking about the dentulous patient also, see, complete denture, we call it edentulous. That means if we are giving a denture completely to a patient, that means there is no teeth left in the patient's mouth. That means E, which is without dentulous, without teeth. And if we talk about FPD or RPD we give, that is going to be our dentulous patient. Dentulous is which are having the teeth, dent. Dent word means the teeth, right? Dentulous. So we'll be talking about in the today's video, most specifically impression materials is a question which is asked from the CD part of the prostho, right? So, and also in the dental materials, this is a question which is asked in the dental materials as well as in the prosthodontics. So no two mouths are alike, same as the fingerprint. We know that no two fingerprints match, right? So like that, there are no two mouth which exactly match or which are similar. So every individual needs a special customized denture for his or her mouth. So the definition according to GPT-4, it comes that it is, impression is defined as the imprint of the teeth. It is not only the imprint of the teeth, it is also the imprints of the adjacent structures which are surrounding the teeth and which is used for the dentistry purpose. So if we talk about the GPT-4 definition, which is the imprint of the teeth as well as the adjacent structures for the use in dentistry. So we'll be talking about, see, the prostho, we mostly talk about the GPT definitions. The one which I've written here is the any substance or the combination of substances used for making the impression or the negative reproduction is the GPT-8 definition, right? And if we talk about GPT-4 definition, then the GPT-4 definition is, GPT-4 definition is, the impression is defined as an imprint. It is defined as an imprint. See, imprint is just the impression. Imprint of the teeth and the adjacent structures. And the adjacent structures for use in the dentistry, so which we use for the dentistry purpose. So now that, see, the definition of the impression is again a question which is asked for Viva, in for second year students in dental materials. Now talking about the today's topic was the which is the impression materials. So if we talk about what is the impression material, according to Hartwell in 1992, impression is defined as an imprint or the negative replica. We need to understand what is a positive replica, what is a negative replica. See, if you are taking a picture via old camera, if you remember the old cameras, they have a film, right? So, or otherwise, if you are taking x-ray, what happens? Suppose this is the person holding something in the right hand, right? So the film which comes is going to be like this. And once we develop it, the photograph comes. This is the film, right? The photograph comes. The photograph will be same exactly like the person. That is the holding the substance in the right hand. So this is the picture. So this is the negative replica. Or if you are pouring something in the mold. Right. So, if you are pouring something in the mold, so you have created a negative replica of it. That means exact copy. If some elevation is there in the original thing, then the depression will come in the negative replica. Right. So, cast is a positive replica, which is exactly we are mimicking the structures which are inside the mouth with the help of a stone or a plaster, right, the gypsum product. So, positive replica is the cast. And negative replica is always the impression. Okay. So, if we are talking about cast, we will be talking about the positive replica. If we are talking about impression, we will be talking about the negative replica. So, according to Hartwell, it is defined as, in 1992, it is the impression is an imprint or the negative likeliness of the teeth or the edentulous areas made in the plastic material which becomes hardened or set while in contact with the tissues. So while it comes in the contact, the all of the impression material, it hardens and it becomes set, and then we get the impression. This is the definition of the impression. So talking about the definition of the impression material, right? So, impression material is the substance, or it can be the combination of substances. So, it is the any substance or the combination of substances which is used for making the impression. Very easy. Combination of substances which is used for making impression, right? So this is the material. So the material which we are taking to record the impression, the material which we are taking to take the impression is the impression material. Very easy. So what are the steps in the impression material? How do we take an impression? Suppose a patient comes to you, if you are a second year student, or if you are a final year student, then you must have done CDs. Or if you are a second year student, you don't know what a CD is. You have never seen, you have never made. So, you have no idea about the complete denture. So, basically what happens is when a patient comes to you, he has no teeth inside the mouth. Then you want to start preparing something on which you can put the teeth, right? Which can sit in the patient's mouth. So, what you are planning to do is you are planning to construct something which is, see, suppose these are the ridges of the patient. This is the upper ridges, these are the lower ridges, right? So this is the ridge. There are no teeth which are present in the ridges. So you want to construct something on which you can place the teeth. So the construction of a base, construction of a base. Suppose if you want to make a building, so you want to put a base. If you are putting anything, if you want to put a dish somewhere, you want to put it on a plate or in a cup or in a bowl. So you need a base, right? So first of all, we need a base, and upon that, on the top of that, we place the teeth. So this is the denture base. First of all, we prepare a denture base, and on the top of the denture base, we put the teeth, and then we set the teeth permanently. So usually we use the heat cure acrylic resin to do that. So if impression basically the first step of the complete denture, because first of all we want to see that how it looks in the patient's mouth, then on the top of that we prepare the denture bases, then on the top of that we put the materials. So what are the steps of making the impression? This is the step of making the complete denture. What are the steps of making the impression? So steps in impression, we require couple of impression because we want exact fitting of the patient mouth. See, making a denture is not like stitching a suit or stitching a dress, because stitching a dress also requires some fitting, because once you go to a tailor shop, you get a dress stitched, then you try it. Sometimes, you know, when you try it, you ask for fitting somewhere here and there, right? So in the denture, what we do is we take the measurements exactly, accurately, so that there are no chances of misfitting, right? So this is what we are doing with the help of an impression. So first step is examination of the patient. The first of all, we examine the patient, examine the frenum, examine the various intraoral structures in the area. So first of all is the examination of the patient, which is usually done in the with the help of a case history. Then the second thing is the selection of the tray. The type of material which we are using is the main thing, and based on that we select the tray. It's not like first of all we need to select the type of the, first of all we need to examine the patient, and then we need to conclude that this is the specific impression material which I want to use for this patient. Again, the question, your question in your mind must be, ma'am, how do we conclude that this is the type of a material which we want to use? Suppose if the patient is having deep undercuts, right? So that case we want to, in the complete denture case, in the complete denture patient, we want to go for the alginate. Usually ideal impression material in CD case is impression compound, which we use in India, right? In the foreign countries, definitely we use the alginate, but in India we use the impression compound. So first of all, what we do is we see, examine the patient's mouth, and then we conclude that this is the specific material which I want to go for. Suppose if you want to go for impression compound, then you want to take the tray without any hole. So that is our non-perforated metallic tray. If you want to go for alginate impression material, then you have to use the perforated tray. So the first thing is the selection of the tray. Then again, there comes two things. One is the selection of the tray based on the material. Another one is the selection of the tray in the patient's mouth. So once I have concluded that I want to take impression from the impression compound in this particular patient, if I want to record impression from the impression compound, then we have to take a tray which is non-perforated, which is a metallic tray, right? So that tray also, we will have a series of trays ranging from different sizes. Then we need to select the tray size which we want to use for this particular patient. So based on the mouth, the arch is small or arch is medium or arch is large. So based on that, while recording the case history, we record this also, the size of the arch of the patient. So based on that, we fit these trays and we see that which tray is accurately fitting, we select the tray. Then there is selection of the impression material, and then we take the impression. We take the impression. So impression making. Impression making also, there is the first impression which we make is the primary impression. Primary impression is the first impression which we make. So primary, this is the primary impression, which is used for diagnosis, which is used for construction of the trays, the special trays. So primary impression, always primary is the word which is used for first. The first impression, as soon as the patient comes, the first impression, we are not going to construct denture bases on that, because that is not the exact fitting. First of all, the first impression which we take, suppose if a person comes to you, suppose if you are a tailor, and if a person comes to you, individual comes to you asking to do the fitting. So the first thing in your head is you check for the size of the person. Either he is XL or L or M or S. Then you take the exact measurements. Then see, then the sometimes when there is a shortage of the cloth material. So sometimes what happens is the person will measure the material and he'll look at your figure and tell that this specific dress material is not enough to stitch this kind of dress, right? So this is the primary analysis, the first analysis. So the same way we first make the primary impression and then we make the secondary impression and the border molding. So then we do the border molding exactly and then we take the secondary impression. Secondary impression is the exact impression. We want to record the exact structures in the patient's mouth. There are so many elevation, depression areas. So the secondary impression is the exact impression on which we want to construct the denture basis. So then we take another impression. The second impression, you can say, is the secondary impression of the patient. So talking about finally the classifications of the impression material, till now we have covered the impression and the impression materials and some basic about the impression materials, right? So we'll be covering some classifications. We will be covering 6 classifications of the impression materials. If you can remember, you can write in the question. If the question has been asked, suppose depending on the, again, the question asked for how many marks. If the question is asked for 5 marks, then maybe out of 6 you can write some important classifications. If the question has been asked for 10 marks, definitely you need to write all the classifications. If asked for 2 marks, then you need to write only the theory. So again, it depends on the type of the question which is asked under how many marks. So talking about the first classification of the impression material, this is the conventional and the digital classification. You must have seen the conventional impression materials, because the digital impression is the impression which is used for recording with a CAD/CAM machine. So this is which will come on the computer screens. This is the digital impression. Again, direct intraoral and indirect extraoral examination which we record from the CAD/CAM. Then next comes the conventional impression, that is the manual impression, the impression which we take from the hand and we see from our eyes. See, before starting taking the impression, we must know that the requirements of the impression material, how the impression material should be, what are the ideal requirements of the impression material, which is not usually frequently asked for the exam purpose, but I need you to know that it should be fluid enough that it records the oral tissues. See, suppose if you are biting hard on a rubber which we use to rub, right? Rub the pencil marks. So if you want to bite hard on the rubber, there is going to be little imprint which will come on the rubber. So that is very hard, that is very inelastic, that is quite some elastic, but there is not exact impression of the teeth which is taken. So what we want to record the teeth, also we want to record the adjacent structures also, right? So for that purpose we want something which is fluid, which flows inside the tissues, and once we insert the impression inside the tissues, after some time, it should be less than 7 minutes, after some times before 7 minutes it should set, and once we take out it is not distorted. So these are all the requirements, and of course it should be cost effective, it should be biocompatible, it should not injure the oral tissues inside the patient mouth. So the ideal requirements are usually that it should adapt to the oral tissues, it should be viscous enough, it should be dimensionally stable, and there should be adequate tear resistance, and the setting time should be less than 7 minutes because we do not want the patient to open the mouth and get fatigued while taking the impression itself, and it should be cost effective. So talking about the conventional impressions, then we have got elastic as well as we have got inelastic impression material. See, once you look at both the impression materials, the difference between elastic and inelastic is that the elastic impression materials are the materials which will be elastic in nature, which will be rubber like. So if we are recording a impression which can compress the tissues, definitely it is going to fall under the elastic impression material. Inelastic impression materials are the impression materials which are not elastic, which are very tight. So these are the inelastic impression materials. So elastic impression materials, we are going to cover one by one each of the impression materials in the videos, upcoming videos. So right now don't worry about all these materials, we are going to cover one by one eventually. But for time being, just remember that hydrocolloid polysulfide, we have reversible and irreversible. Irreversible material is that material which we can heat it and reuse it in the patient mouth. So reversible, the example can be the agar. Agar can be an example of reversible. Irreversible alginate can be an example of irreversible hydrocolloid impression material. And then we have got polysulfide, polyether, additional silicon, condensational silicon, and again polyether. Then coming to inelastic. Inelastic, we have got impression plaster, impression waxes, impression compound, and zinc oxide eugenol paste. Inelastic impression material will cover in one video. Elastic impression material we are going to cover in single video in the upcoming videos. But for that you need to subscribe. Only 50% of the student had subscribed to our channel. 40% in fact, I must say, because it is the ratio is 43% of the students are subscribed. Rest of the student, they watch the channel and it seems like they feel like there is some charge they have to pay for subscription. My lovely students, subscribing a channel is free of cost. If we are taking some time, extra time to teach you for free, then it is your duty from your end to leave a comment in the comment section if you have enjoyed the video, if you have liked the video, or if there is any query you feel, if there are any questions, so you need to comment in the comment section below. So talking about the next classification, which is based on the degree of the compression and the amount of pressure applied. This is a very, very, very important classification, and in fact I have marked star in front of it because it is a very important classification. The question which is asked is the classification for the theories of impression making or the theories of impression making. Again, this is a separately asked question. This question can be asked for 5 marker. This question can be asked for 10 marker for PG students. So it is a very, very important question which is asked for student exam, and you need to open your eyes if you are sleeping. So the based on the degree of the tissue compressibility, what does it mean? It means that how much the tissue can compress. If you are putting pressure, if you are taking impression, you are putting pressure on the tissues, and the amount of pressure you are applying. Based on that, we have got the mucostatic, mucocompressive, and selective pressure theories. So before we get start ahead with the theories of impression making, first of all, we should know that what is the mucocompressive. So which compresses the mucosa. Mucosa, what is mucosa? Mucosa is basically the soft tissue which is present in the, which is covering the bone, on which we are putting the dentures. So that is the mucosa, right? So mucosa is the soft tissue covering the bone on which the denture base rest. Mucosa, based on the location of the mucosa, based on its location in the mouth, it is divided into, mucosa is divided into 3 types. The masticatory mucosa, the lining mucosa, and the specialized mucosa. So in the mouth, the masticatory mucosa covers the 25% of the area. So the masticatory mucosa is the mucosa, is the soft tissue basically, which covers the ridge, the supporting structures of the bone. So it can be a hard palate, covering the hard palate. Then comes the lining mucosa. it covers 60%. It is, see, the masticatory mucosa is the non-keratinized. The lining mucosa, masticatory mucosa is the keratinized, is the keratinized. Hard palate is keratinized, right? So the lining mucosa is non-keratinized. The vestibular space, alveolingual sulcus, the soft tissues, unattached gingiva or the ventral surface. See, the dorsal is the uppermost surface of the tongue which covers the papillae. The ventral is beneath. So the ventral surface of the tongue, these all are the things which covers underlining mucosa. Then comes the specialized mucosa, which is the 15%. It covers the dorsal surface of the tongue because it has got, why specialized? Because it has got the papillae, right? So papillae, this is a mucosa wherein we cannot see somewhere else in the mouth. So this is only seen in the tongue, on the tongue. So the dorsal surface of the tongue, again specialized, is also keratinized. Lining is the non-keratinized mucosa. So, talking about, now that we know that mucosa and mucocompressive is, which can compress the mucosa. So, mucocompressive, mucostatic, as well as selective pressure theories. Talking about the mucostatic impression technique. So, as the name suggests, mucostatic. Muco means mucosa. Mucosa and static means remain static, that means remains the same. So mucostatic is the impression material wherein no pressure is applied. So the mucosa remains the static. So impression material is not compressing the soft tissues. So suppose this is our soft tissue, this is the bone, and if we are applying, if we are putting impression material, suppose here is our impression material, right? This is the impression material. So this is the impression material. It is not compressing the soft tissues. So that is going to be the mucostatic impression material, which is not compressing the soft tissues. With the one which is compressing the soft tissues is going to be mucocompressive. So, talking about mucostatic impression material, there is no pressure which is applied and therefore it does not displace the soft tissues at the border. And this is the reason that the retention is not good for these cases. So, there is no pressure, no pressure which is applied in the, no pressure. No pressure is applied, and therefore this is the reason that it does not displace the soft tissues at the borders, and this is the reason therefore the retention is not good. Retention is not good. Okay. Now, so there is a lack of the peripheral seal. Suppose if there is no retention, that means from the borders there is going to be not tight adhesion. So if we give the denture in this case, suppose if we give the denture here, what will happen? The denture will not be that tight. So the denture will have a fitting here. Will have a fitting here. But there is going to be space, mild space, not this much space, but mild space at the border. So the retention will not be there and there is going to be the lack of the peripheral seal. And since there is no pressure which is applied, so also it's a non-pressure technique. So the flanges of the denture are going to be shortened and it will not support the lips and the cheek. But there is one important thing. So there is one important thing, which is the tissue health is preserved. Very important, because it is not compressing the tissues. Suppose constantly, if I keep on pressing your hand, your wrist, all the times, what will happen? It will start paining eventually. So when there is no compression, there is no force which is applied due to denture on the tissues. So the tissue health is preserved because there is no pressure which is applied. Okay, preserved. And the health is maintained. Therefore, it is suitable in the areas where there is sharp residual ridges, and there is going to be flat, flabby ridges. So what happens? Suppose if a person is sitting on a very sharp object, so what will happen? The patient will have pain, right? He'll have pain sensation. So same way, what happens? The knife edge ridges, they are very sharp. They are, see, suppose the normal ridges are round, like, right? So if there is a resorption, what happens? Because of the resorption, there are very sharp ridges. So if we seat a denture on this ridge, so what will happen? There is going to be impingement from here. So same like as a person is sitting on a very sharp object, same likewise the patient will start having pain. So we are not putting, because this pressure is not putting pressure on the tissues. So this is the reason that we have talked about, that this is not putting pressure, and therefore it is also known as the minimal pressure technique. So it is also known as the minimal pressure technique because there is no pressure which is applied here. So the mucostatic impression technique is also known as the minimal pressure technique. And also it obeys the Pascal law, which states that the pressure applied on the liquid will be equally transmitted through the liquid. So suppose this is a liquid. If we apply the pressure on a liquid, then there is going to be equal transmission from all the sides of the liquid, throughout the liquid. So according to this technique, the impression material should record without the distortion, and it should record every single detail of the mucosa so that the denture would fit in all the minute details, all the elevation, all the depression. Suppose if any small elevation is there, because it is not compressing the tissues, so even a small elevation and depression is recorded because it is not compressing the tissues. So whatever is there remains the same and it is recorded likewise. So it is used in case of the metal denture bases. It is used in case of the metal denture bases. Also, there is no direct pressure over the sharp bony ridges. So in the sharp bony ridges, and this mucostatic impression technique was given by Edison in 1994, described this technique, and it is attributed to Page, Henry Page, right? Talking about the mucocompressive technique, we have talked about which compresses the tissues. So the mucocompressive technique is going to put the pressure on the tissues. So it is a definite pressure technique, definite pressure impressions. So it is also known as definite pressure impressions. And it is going to compress the tissues. So many dentists, you know, believe that it is essential that the denture remain in contact while chewing, because while chewing there is a pressure on, and in this pressure, little bit of pressure, there is going to be very tight contact. So the denture remain in contact while chewing. So it is logical to press the tissues so that while the patient is chewing, the denture doesn't come out. So the advantage is that of this mucocompressive impression technique is that there is going to be good retention, especially during the function. So good retention while chewing, and at the same time it produces pressure to the supporting areas, to the supporting bone. Now if it is causing pressure on the supporting bone, what will happen? If there is a pressure on the bone, then the bone starts resorbing, right? So there is going to be the resorption of the ridge, and the denture will seat well during mastication, but it is going to, see, tissues have got the tendency to rebound, right? So suppose this is the tissue, this is the bone. Suppose what happens if you are going to compress the tissues constantly when while chewing the teeth. Now let's see. This is the denture, right? And on the top of that there are teeth. So what happens? It is going to compress the tissues while chewing, while the teeth are in contact. So it will compress, it will put pressure. First of all, there is going to be the resorption. Second thing is that when there is no compression, tissues has got a tendency. So tissue will come here. There is going to be a little bit of compression of the soft tissues. So what will happen when there is no pressure, when there is no occlusal contact, then tissue will come to its original position. So there is going to be slight lifting of the denture. So that will result in the premature contacts. So one is the resorption, another one is the premature contacts. While this is due to the rebounding tendency of the tissues. The next comes the selective pressure technique. Selective pressure technique is a combination of mucostatic plus mucocompressive, which is given by Boucher. So it is a combination of mucocompressive. Now first what we do is we take a mucostatic impression, we take a mucocompressive impression. So the primary impression which we are taking, I'll be writing primary impression like this. Primary impression we are going to relieve the areas like midline, incisive papilla. Because what will happen if we are putting pressure on these area, there is going to be harm to the patient. So we are relieving all these areas in the primary impression, and then we are taking the secondary impression, or you can say the wash impression. Okay, then it records the relieved areas with the minimal pressure. So there is going to be pressure on the mucosa over the ridge that can withstand the pressure, and there is going to be relief in the midline. So we are going to give relief in the relief areas. And we are going to put pressure over the stress bearing areas. So this is the selective pressure that selectively, as the name suggests, selectively we are going to put pressure. And mucocompressive is we are just compressing the tissues. Mucostatic is when there is no pressure which is applied, the tissues remain as it is. It is a very important classification which is based on the theories of the impression. So if the question is asked the theories of the impression, we have to write the mucostatic, mucocompressive as well as the selective pressure theory. So mucocompressive impression material, it is going to be compress the tissues, the example of which can be impression compound, which is going to compress the tissues. All the elastic impression material again will come into compressive, waxes, and then we have got the soft liners, right? Mucostatic, there is going to be example of impression plaster. Right. So guys, this is about the theories of the impression making. Next comes the, based on the type of the impression and the areas it has been used. So dentulous means the patient is having teeth inside the mouth. Edentulous is the patient is having no teeth inside. So if some teeth are present, then it is dentulous, right? Or all the teeth are present. If edentulous, some or all. If edentulous, that means no teeth. E means without. ठीक है. Then comes the primary and secondary for both of them. The primary impression, again I've told you, the primary impression is the one which is used for diagnostic purposes, which is the first impression which has been made. So primary impression is the impression which is made for diagnosis or which is used for construction of the tray. Secondary impression, on the other hand, is used for making the master cast. So the primary impression in the dentulous, we can use the alginate, and the secondary we can use the agar. Alginate is irreversible. Once we take impression from the alginate, we cannot reuse the alginate. So it is irreversible hydrocolloid. So if we talk about, previously we have covered the reversible hydrocolloid and the irreversible hydrocolloid under the elastic impression materials. So reversible hydrocolloid can be, example can be agar. So agar, if you take impression from agar and you take the impression out, you pour the cast, you can take the impression out, and if the impression is not come correctly, then again you can reuse the agar. Irreversible is alginate. Once you have taken the impression, you cannot reuse the alginate impression material. You have to throw the material and again you have to mix it and take the impression, right? So hydrocolloid, we have got reversible and irreversible. Then we will come again back to the dentulous secondary impression. We have got the agar and we have got elastomers. Coming to edentulous. Edentulous, we have got again primary, secondary. Primary, which we most often use, is the impression compound, which is the most frequently material which is used. Then comes the impression plaster. Impression plaster, all these materials, see, you don't have to get worried right now, we'll cover one by one all the materials. Then next comes, also we use the alginate. So alginate we use it when there are undercuts, deep undercuts which are present. When there is a flabby tissue which is present, we take impression from the impression plaster. Flabby tissues, flabby means mobile tissues, that means the tissues are moving. Alginate is when there are undercuts which are present, deep undercuts which are present, then we take from alginate. Impression compound is the ideal impression material which we use still in India. So coming to secondary impression material, the most common impression material which we use is the zinc oxide eugenol impression paste and the elastomers which we use for complete dentures. Right, so this is the dentulous, another classification based on the type of the impression and the area of the use. Next comes the based on the manipulation. So based on the manipulation, there can be hand mixing. So we can mix the impression material from the hand, and if you can see the kneading, the impression compound, both the hands we are going to mix it like small piece of clay, how we mix the clay, right? The same way we do the kneading. So kneading, it is what we do for impression compound. And also, see, impression compound, we are doing the wet kneading. That means we are putting in the water bath. And also we use it for the putty consistency elastomers. Putty consistency is the clay-like consistency of the elastomers. Then next one we have is the circular motion. Circular motion, or we can do it in a glass slab and with the help of a spatula. So this is an example of zinc oxide eugenol impression paste. The white one is the base paste, the red one is the catalyst paste, and we have mixed both in a circular motion. So you know, like this, in a circular with the help of spatula. Suppose I'm holding a spatula, and in a circular motion with the help on a glass slab. So this motion, again, this comes under hand mixing. We have got hand mixing, and the mechanical mixing is what we do it while doing. Mechanical mixing is what we do with the help of machines, right? So coming to circular motion, we have got the Zeddo impression paste, and also we do for polysulfides. That to very light consistency. coming to vigorous mixing. Vigorous mixing is when we are mixing with vigorously, like very fast, like that. So in a plastic bowl. Suppose if you are mixing alginate. So for alginate, we use the vigorous motion of mixing. This is impression material. Vigorous mixing also we do for POP, plaster of Paris, and this is the reason that I have written plaster of Paris over here, but that is not the impression materials. If we talk about impression compound, impression plaster, then yes, then I need to specify it that this is an impression plaster. Not plaster of Paris. Okay. Then alginate, we use it the figure of 8 motion. Figure of 8. That means you are moving your hand like a 8, like how you are making a 8. So big 8, like how you are making, you are mixing in a bowl, rubber bowl. So next one is according to their method of use. So how the consistency we are getting, how the method which we are using. Suppose if you are using as a tray material, suppose if you are using it as a tray material, so if you are using it as a tray material, we use heavy body or putty body elastomers, heavy body or putty body elastomers, putty consistency elastomers we use as a tray material. Then we have got the syringe material. So all the light body, that means they come in the syringes, and then we mix it. And sometimes nowadays the syringes we are getting is the pre-mixed, so we don't have to even mix it, we just need to put it and place in the patient mouth. So that is the light body elastomers. Or syringe material we have got agar also. Then comes the primary impression. So primary impression for CD cases, we use the impression compound. We have already talked about. See, all these impression materials we are going to talk about one by one. Also, we use the putty consistency of the elastomers. So putty elastomers. Putty consistency, remember, see, there are many consistencies. Putty consistency of the elastomer is like clay-like. And light body is like paste, like Colgate. So these are slightly thinner, in fact thinner than Colgate. So secondary impression material is our zinc oxide eugenol impression paste, as well as the light body. Both we use for taking, recording fine impression, because they are very thin, the viscosity is very thin. So light body. Next comes the special uses, in that we have got gutta-percha GP. Gutta-percha. Then comes, based on the tray which is used for the impression. So we have got the stock tray. Stock tray is the one, if you can see, the one which we have got from the shop. Special tray is what we do according to the individual. So special tray is a special, or we can say the customized tray. Right? So custom tray or the special tray, which is a customized tray, that means we are using for this specific person. If you can see in this diagram over here, there is a cast. This is the cast of the patient, and on that patient we have constructed a tray. But if we look at the stock trays, stock, as we know that there is going to be a stock in our storeroom. So imagine that you are taking a tray out of your storeroom. So this is a stock tray which is already present, which is made or fabricated on an ideal, fabricated from the ideal ridge, you can say, or from the ideal impression, you can say. So it will have different sizes, so ranging on the large, extra large, 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. We have got, if you can see here, we have got the 4 size tray. If you see here, we have got the upper 5, U5, that means upper 5. If you see here, plastic, we will have, this must be a larger size. This is for the water coolant tray. So basically, stock trays are the trays which are manufactured not in your dental lab, which are actually manufactured in the factory. So that is the stock tray, right? Then special tray is the one which we manufacture in our dental laboratory. So this is the special tray, and it the special tray of one individual will not fit into the special tray of another individual, because I told you in the beginning, no two mouths are alike, no two mouths are same like fingerprints. So the stock tray, you can use it again and again on different individual, but the special tray is customized tray. So special tray we use for making a secondary impression, which is the accurate impression, and the stock tray we use for taking the primary impression, special tray for secondary impression. So based on the type of trays, we have got stock tray, we have got the special tray. So the stock tray, we have got again subtypes of stock trays. So the subtypes of stock trays is type of tray and type of perforation. So the type of tray is rim lock tray, water coolant tray, or plastic tray. So rim lock tray is what will be there. Suppose if this is a normal tray, rim lock tray, there is going to be a wide area over here, a very thick area like this. That means it is locked from the rims. Rims means periphery. As you can see here, we have got a thick area, right? So this is a rim lock tray. But again, this one is not a rim lock tray because there are very fine borders. If they are very thick borders, then it is going to be a rim lock tray. Thin borders, normal tray. If thick borders, then there is going to be the rim lock tray, right? So rim lock tray is thick at the borders. Normal tray is thin at the borders. Then we have got the water cooled tray. See, the rim lock trays again, which we used for agar. The water coolant tray, the alginate, which we used for alginate. The water coolant tray is what we use for agar, because we want the agar to set from the cooled water. So there is going to be water inlet and water outlet. So water will come inside, flow everywhere, and will go out. So like that, there is going to be inlet for water, outlet for water, as you can see here, the pipes. So this tray, if you see here, this is the water cooled tray, which is used for agar impression. Then we have got the plastic tray. So the plastic tray is normally which is made of plastic, which is not made of metal. So one can be metallic tray, another can be plastic tray. You can put it this way also. So the another one is the type of the perforation. The type of perforation, that means if there are perforations which are present in the tray, as you can see here, there are holes which are present, the perforations which are present here. So that is the perforated tray, which is used for alginate. So this is used for, this one is used for alginate. If you see the non-perforated tray, this is the non-perforated tray. There are no holes in the tray, which is used for impression compound. Right, for taking edentulous impressions. So guys, this is about the classification of the impression materials. I know that we have stretched little bit video longer, but it is very important. If you are a second year student, it is very important for you to understand these things. So we have covered the impression classification, which is the imprint of the teeth, and the supporting structures, which is used in the dentistry. So this is the GPT 4 definition. Then we have covered the steps, then we have covered the classification. Again, this is a very important classification, the mucostatic, mucocompressor, and the selective pressure theory, based on the theories of the impression material. And then we have covered based on the type of the impression and the area of use, the dentulous, edentulous. This is very easy. These rest of these classifications are very easy. Then based on the manipulation, hand mixing, mechanical mixing, hand mixing, we have covered the kneading, circular motion, and vigorous mixing. In that we have studied the alginate figure of eight according to their method of use, tray material, syringe material, primary impression, secondary impression, and the gutta percha based on the tray which is used for the impression, the stock tray and the special tray. The special tray, this is the resin tray, which is shown in the diagram. So this is the resin. So that also we will cover in one of the chapters of the dental materials, and also we can use the base plate wax. Then we have got the stock trays. In the stock trays we have got the type of trays, rimlocked, water cooled, plastic trays, and the type of perforation we have perforated or non-perforated tray. So if you have enjoyed the video, then give it a thumbs up, and if you have any questions, you can leave it in the comment below. Also make sure you subscribe to our channel if you haven't done it yet, to get more videos like this, more videos more often. So guys, thank you, take care, bye bye, keep reading, keep learning, stay motivated. I'll see you soon in the next video.